Svelte is an innovative and powerful JavaScript framework that has been gaining popularity amongst web developers. In fact, it was voted the second most loved web technology in 2022 in the Stack Overflow survey, cementing its position as a formidable leader in the front-end space. This video will compare Svelte and React, which has long been the most popular choice for building websites. Unlike React, which relies on a browser runtime and virtual DOM, Svelte compiles your code into highly optimized JavaScript at build time, resulting in lightning-fast application with small client-side bundles. While Svelte differs from React in its approach to rendering, both frameworks share many fundamental concepts, such as components, props, event listeners, and state. This means that your React knowledge can be a solid foundation for learning Svelte. To get started, check out the Svelte tutorial on svelte.dev, listed in the description. Svelte uses .svelte files for its components, where you can define your JavaScript or TypeScript, templating, and style code all in one file, making it easy to organize your project. Inside the script tag, you can define reactive component state as variables using let. Instead of JSX, you can use Svelte's templating to render the variable with curly braces. For conditional statements, use if blocks, followed by else if and else branches as needed. To bind an event handler to an element, use the on directive followed by the event name. Define handlers as functions in your script, or use inline handlers, which, unlike React, do not have any performance overhead. Update the component state by assigning a new value to the variable, and Svelte will automatically re-render the component. Svelte provides the each block to iterate over arrays. Each allows destructuring values, and a second property is provided for the index. Instead of using a key prop like React, you can define the item's key at the end of the each inside parentheses. Note that when updating state, you must always reassign the variable. Mutating the inner state of an array or object is not detected. To work around this, you can reassign a variable to itself to force an update. You can set modifiers for events, such as prevent default to prevent the default browser handling of the event, or wants to have the handler automatically removed after being triggered. Svelte styling is component scope, meaning no need to worry about accidentally breaking other components. You can use the global selector to define global styles. To conditionally render classes on an element, use the class directive, followed by a class name. The class will be applied when the attribute's value is true. You can also use a preprocessor by setting the lang attribute on the style tag. Importing and using components is similar to React. First, use an import statement in the script tag, then render the component in the template passing props as key value pairs. You can also use the spread syntax to pass in an object as multiple props, or omit the prop name if it matches the variable's name. To receive props from a parent component, simply export a variable. Optionally, define a default by setting its initial value. In Svelte, components use slots to render children. Use a slot tag to render elements passed to a component. Optionally, set a fallback by adding content inside the slot tag. Svelte also supports name slots, which allows you to pass in multiple sets of children with different names. To render a name slot, set the name attribute on a slot tag and use the slot attribute on an element in the parent. You can define computed variables using the $:: syntax. This powerful feature is a bit of Svelte magic, and yes, it's valid JavaScript. Here, half is defined to be recomputed whenever count changes. You can also use $ to run code whenever a variable changes. Note that this will only run when a variable used inside the statement is updated. You can also define a block for multiple statements with curly braces, or you can conditionally run code using an if statement. Like HTML elements, you can subscribe to component events with the on directive. To dispatch events in the component, you must create an event dispatcher and call it with the event name as the first argument, followed by any data for the event. While React doesn't have two-way data bindings, you can achieve this in Svelte using bind. This will ensure that changes to the input element's value are reflected in the variable, and vice versa. Svelte uses this bindings to replace React's ref. After rendering, the variable given to bind this will be assigned to the DOM element. You can use the variable inside the onMount lifecycle, which is run once a component is mounted. Use the onDestroy lifecycle handler for component unmounting, which is useful for cleaning up resources like timers. Additionally, you can use before update and after update to listen for changes before and after rendering. Svelte provides a built-in global state management solution. You can create a writable store to share a variable across your application using writable and initial value. The store's state can be changed using the update or set methods, and you can listen to changes using the subscribe method, similar to observables. To use the value of the store reactively, prefix it with a dollar sign. Svelte also includes read-only and derived stores for more advanced functionality. Svelte's context API, similarly to React, enables sharing state between components. Unlike stores, which are global, context only applies to the children of components that call setContext. Parent components must call setContext at the top level with a key, usually a symbol, and children must use getContext with the same key at the top level. In this example, the parent component sets an object with getCanvas that returns the bind to the canvas, and the child component calls getContext and getCanvas to retrieve the value. Note that since the canvas variable is only set after the component is mounted, the context must have a getter instead of the value itself. Svelte boasts a rich ecosystem of high-quality libraries. Some features, such as state management, which previously required external libraries in React, are integrated into Svelte. Additionally, Svelte's component scope CSS offers an excellent solution for styling. To address the need for full React frameworks like Next.js and Remix, Svelte developers created SvelteKit, a powerful meta framework which supports features such as file system routing, multiple rendering strategies, including server-side rendering, and simplified data loading. To begin working with SvelteKit, create a project with this npm create command and follow the prompt, then install dependencies using npm I. Within source pages, you'll find the router pages for the project, while lib contains library code for components and utilities. To get started, clear out any existing content and create a +page.svelte file for your index page. It's important to note that files prefixed with plus are special in SvelteKit. For example, here are some example routes and their corresponding paths. You can also use +page.ts to load data or +page.server.ts to run code on the server side. Additionally, +error pages can be used to display errors and +layout pages for nesting page layouts. To create a simple to-do application within our page file, we'll first define the state for our input field and our to-dos. Then, create an input element with the value attribute bound to the state variable. Next, add a button to submit the form and attach the form submit event to a callback function. Be sure to include prevent default to avoid page reload. Within the callback function, update the state of the to-dos array by appending the input's value to the end and reset the input. To render the items, add an each block with the to-do text as the key within the parentheses. To allow deleting items, add a button next to each rendered to-do. In the button's click handler, filter out the current to-do and update the state accordingly. To complete the application, add some styling by creating a class for the input field and another for the to-do section. To deploy the application, push the code to a GitHub repository. Then, navigate to vercel.com to create a new application. Select your GitHub repo, click Deploy, and wait for the process to complete. After a minute, visit the generated link to view your application. To conclude, Svelte offers a powerful and innovative approach to front-end development, making it a great choice for building web applications. Whether you're an experienced front-end developer or just starting, Svelte is definitely worth considering for your next project. Thank you for watching, and if you enjoyed this content, please consider subscribing and liking for more videos like this.